Hey, Junkyard John here. Welcome to another fantastic webisode of Dumpsterpiece Theater, a blast from the past. These are shows we did a few years back over at K-Hell TV station back somewhere in the Cantaloupe Valley. And this one is a little deal we did on the Master of the Flying Guillotine, which I had a pretty good public domain copy of, and we showed it. And Stacy and I spent the entire show mixing about 19 or 20 different European prog bands, all kinds of weird stuff to supplement the soundtrack. So one of these days we might release that episode, but it was funny, after we showed this, we got contacted by one of the people who owns the American rights to Master of the Flying Guillotine as far as this new remastered version is concerned. And we thought we were all getting in trouble, getting busted for it and something. And the guy was really nice about it, and he just let us know when the special edition was released. So that is finally out on DVD now. So if you see the Master of the Flying Guillotine special edition, grab it, because it has extra footage I've never seen before. And it's a much cleaner copy than any of the PD copies. So there's the plug, and enjoy it for what it is. But you'll see what this little clip that we have here. We had a little bit of fun with bad dubbing in movies, and also give you an idea of some of the music we used overlaying some of the sequences. So without further ado, here is that little bit of Master of the Flying Guillotine as it appeared on Dumpsterpiece Theater.
Welcome back to Dumpsterpiece Theater. Welcome back to Dumpsterpiece Theater.
Huh? What's wrong with your voice, Junkyard John? Oh my goodness, my voice appears to be affected as well.
I think something queer is going on.
You're darn right. Wait a minute. I never say darn.
I have a theory, Alfonso.
Oh?
It appears to me that our whole segment has been poorly dubbed into English.
Oh! But how can that be? We are speaking live and other voices are heard.
I don't know, young rat friend, but stay calm, and we'll soon find a solution to our dilemma. Control room. Control room.
Yeah?
This is Junkyard John. Come in, please.
Yeah, we're having a problem here. Looks like our movie's got some problem with the bleed over or something, a cable problem. It's influencing your dialogue.
What do you mean?
Well, it's making the dubbing. It's giving a problem to the dubbing. I got Stacy working on it right now, you know. Sorry.
Well, then, as Mark and Stacy make the necessary repairs, we'll go back to our movie, Master of the Flying Guillotine, and hopefully we'll have our regular voices back.
I'm scared, John.
So am I.
So, do you want to fight?
You are my nemesis.
And you are mine.
Prepare to be destroyed. Pull my finger and feel my wrath.
I am no match for your finger, but you'll soon taste my hot winds of death.
Them off. They should be clear by now.
Hmm. Good. Come inside and we'll have a talk.
To the town of our free rode a stranger one fine day. Hardly spoke to folks around him, didn't have too much to say. No one dared to ask his business, no one dared to make a slip. The stranger there among them had a big iron on his hip. Big iron on his hip. It was early in the morning when he rode into the town. He came riding from the south side, slowly looking all around. He's an outlaw loose and running, came the whisper from each lip. And he's here to do some business with a big iron on his hip. Big iron on his hip. In this town there lived an outlaw by the name of Texas Red. Many men had tried to take him, and that many men were dead.
Theater, I am stupid idiot Junkyard John, and I stink because I use no soap.
And I'm Alfonso the Rat, and I wet the bed on a daily basis.
Alfonso, did you know I pick my nose and eat my boogers?
I do eat boogers, and I also retrieve soiled maxi pads from the wastebasket.
When I was in high school, I showered with my underwear on.
I listened to boy bands. That NSYNC show was killer.
They call me the one-armed boxer when I look at bra ads.
I love watching Oprah.
My butt smelled like cheese.
I hunt stuffed animals.
You know, we should probably take a look at what's going on with this. Alfonso, I'm going to take a look into the control room.
Taking it, taking it.
What is going on in here? Help me, please.
I don't know, I don't know. Mark told me he reorganized all this stuff.
Come on. Oh, no, you cannot be serious.
I don't know. I don't, wait.
This will not do.
I think I found it. No.
Oh.
That's not it.
What have you?
It's gotta be your
color. No. Oh, keep looking, keep looking.
Have you seen anything yet, John?
No, they have not found a thing.
What the hell is going on here?
What do you mean?
Nothing.
Nothing.
Nothing what at do you all. Mean?
Don't give me that. Come here.
No.
Come here.
No.
Get out of here, you little bastards. Get.
Yeah. Oh.
Just happened!
Alfonso, I found our... Oh, hold on a second.
Hey, Alfonso, what happened? What happened?
I found our trouble. We had subterfuge in our midst.
What the hell does that mean?
It means a couple of our lackeys got a little bit crazy on us and started taking over the show.
Those bastards!
I think we're going to have to beat them severely. What do you think?
Yes!
All right, wasn't that a lot of fun? Yeah, you bet. That was our little jab at badly dubbed foreign films, which, of course, the original American version of Master of the Flying Guillotine was very badly dubbed. But interestingly enough, when they dubbed it, I forgot where, I think over in England, they used Noi and, let's see, Tangerine Dream and some Kraftwerk. And if you hear the original American version, you'll hear those bands in it quite clandestinely, I believe, because they didn't get any kind of screen credit. Another little deal was the music that we played, that we kind of like resupplied through there, was Marty Robbins' Big Iron from Gunfighter Ballads and Other Trail Songs, one of the classic country albums. It's a must-have, absolutely must-have. If you like old-style country, storytelling type stuff, and it has Tom Paul and the Glacier Brothers doing the background vocals, and it's a perfect album. It's just a perfect album, and it has bonuses and extras, so take that, Columbia. We're actually giving you a plug, so there. And that's about it. We had Donnie Burke and Bill Rieger, of course, part of the Dumpsterpiece players in there, screwing around with their voices, and Mark Hall and Stacey Spiegel doing the work in the control room and pretending like they were tearing the station apart, which literally that wasn't too far from being so far-fetched. We were constantly tearing that station apart to get it to work, or Mark was anyway. Luckily, he still has hair in his head because he wasn't pulling it out in there. So that's about it. I can't think of anything else to ramble about this episode. So until next time, I hope you enjoyed that. And if you're watching this anywhere around the world, say hi to your neighbors. Bye.
Where's my pub? Brrrr.